Yeah. Good morning. Today we are in the lecture 13. So we are discussing the cleaning and ventilation of sewer system in a sanitary sewage as well as storm water sewage. So in the last class we have discussed the topics of inspection methods, the cleaning of sewers, how to do some inspection process, and also the various apparatus in the sewer system. So in this class we will discuss the other topic, that is cleaning and ventilation of sewer system. Cleaning and ventilation of sewer system. So here we will discuss the main topics, that is how the ventilation should be done, how the ventilation should be given for any sewer design, so that a sewer should have a proper design as well as it should have a proper configuration. Now, so what are the main objectives of cleaning of the sewers? That is, we'll discuss in this class. What are the main objectives of cleaning and ventilation of the sewer system? First thing, what is the thing? To determine the equipment. So we have to first determine what are the type of equipments we are having for designing the system. What are the various equipments you are having? What are the types of equipments? And what is the length, the design of the sewer? Based upon the design of the sewer, we have to choose the various types of apparatuses and equipment. Also, we have to choose the manpower also. We have to choose the staffing for various sewer methods. Next, second one. To set up a sewer clearing and cleaning equipment carefully and appropriately. So we have to, once we have studied what are the type of equipments we are using, what are the staff things we have, what are the staffing we are taking. Next, we have to set up the cleaning equipment carefully and appropriately. The third one, to operate and maintain the sewer cleaning equipment without harm and effectively. Once you have decided what type of equipments to be taken, once you have decided what type of equipments you have chosen, then you have to go for the operations and maintenance, right? Automatically the operation should be done and you have to maintain the cleaning of equipment without any problem. Next, fourth one, to record the necessary data pertaining to the clearing and cleaning operations. So once the process is going on, once the process of cleaning and ventilation is going on, we have to go for the further recording. Recording means it may be in many forms. One recording may be in a visual recording. Second one is writing in a document form. Third one is by taking the video recording so that it will be used for the further reference in the future process. So like this, these are the main objectives to study for cleaning of the sewer system. Next. Then, what are the reasons for cleaning the sewer and manhole? Why we have to clean the sewers? What are the main reasons? What are the main reasons for cleaning sewer and manholes? First one, to remove the stoppages and obstruction. See, so this is a material which is just a pipe. You can see outside in the outside areas. So to remove the stoppages and obstruction. So what is the first reason? To remove the stoppages and obstruction. Whenever the wastewater is coming, sewer water is coming from the pipe, we should stop the solid materials which are coming into the sewer pipes, right? We have to block those materials. Then only the liquid sewer material is passing in the pipe very neatly. What is the second one? To reduce the complaints regarding the bad odor. What is the other reason for cleaning? So whenever the sanitary water is coming through the different various pipes, through different various manholes, automatically inside the inorganic compounds are developed, thereby some sort of chemical mixing of solutions takes place, then what happens at that time? So you are getting some bad odor. Odor means the smell. You are getting bad smell, so that we have to reduce the complaints of the bad smell coming from this sewerage system. And what is the next one? To minimize the overflow and ponding of sewage. So what is the main thing? We have to reduce the overflow of the sewer water and ponding of sewage. So whenever you are not properly maintaining the manholes, whenever you are not closing the manholes properly, whenever you are not doing the process, then automatically what happens here? There is a problem of overflow in the manhole. Also ponding of sewage takes place. Ponding means akkadanta madugulaga ready ayipothu. So when now you are not maintaining properly, what happens? Ponding as the manhole or any other your drain pipe, whatever the stream water, drain water at that place, a pond. If you see in the roadsides, on the roadsides also, మీకు ఎప్పుడు మీ ఇంటి దగ్గర లేకపోతే ఒక స్ట్రీట్ దగ్గర ఎప్పుడు చూసినా ఆ పాండింగ్ ఆ మురుగు అనేది అట్లనే ఉంటుంది. వై? బికాస్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ మెయింటైనింగ్ ద మ్యాన్ హోల్స్ ప్రాపర్లీ, ఆర్ ఓవర్ ఫ్లో జరగడం వల్ల పాండింగ్ అనేది జరిగింది. సో లైక్ దిస్ యు హావ్ టు టేక్ కేర్ ఫర్ మినిమైజింగ్ ద ఓవర్ ఫ్లో. సో దీస్ ఆర్ ద మెయిన్ రీజన్స్ ఫర్ క్లీనింగ్ ద సీవర్స్ అండ్ మ్యాన్ హోల్. నెక్స్ట్, what are the factors to be considered for proper cleaning? So sewers, sewer pipes, manholes and the other places where you want to get cleaned, what are the factors to be considered? The first one is assess the condition of manholes. So we have to see what is the current situation of the manhole, whether the manhole is properly maintaining or not, whether the manhole is having the proper cover on the manhole or not, how the diameters are designed, is there any scale formation on the manhole. So first you have to assess the condition. So we have to check the condition of the manholes, whether they are properly working or not. Next, the depth of the sewer. We have to check. The other consideration is we have to see the what is the maximum and minimum depth of the sewer pipe whenever during the design of sewer system. So during the design of sewer system, an engineer or a personnel will keep the sewer pipe to certain distance. So we have to consider that distance also whenever you are cleaning for the sewer pipeline. Next, the size of the pipe. So before cleaning of the sewage process, we have to check the size, the diameters of the pipe. Before cleaning of this one, you have to check for the size of the pipe. Next, the depth and type of solid material to be removed. So we have to see what type of solid material is to be removed. Why? Because in the sanitary sewage, along with the liquid, you are getting solid matter also, right? You are getting solid matter also. So what type of solid matter it should be removed? Some solid matters will mix with the liquid and goes along with the liquid. Some solid matters will not mix, will not get decomposed. Then that type of solid matters we have to remove, and we have to see up to what extent, up to how much depth the solid matter is occupying the liquid. For example, if you are having a liquid space or a liquid a certain depth, so on the top layer, how much amount of solid matter is derbis, how much amount of the solid matter is occupying, adi 1 feet unda, half feet unda, 2 feet unda, just you have to verify it. Next, the degree of root intrusion. So we have to check the size. We have to check the maximum and minimum root intrusion process. Means whenever you are laying the sewer pipe in the ground, you have to see for the maximum and minimum root clearances. We have to see the maximum minimum root intrusions. Next, amount of flow. So you have to see what is the rate of flow. So during the rainy season, what is the rate of flow? During the non-rainy season, what is the rate of flow? During the dry seasons, what is the rate of flow? Based upon the rate of flow also, you have to check how many times you have to go for cleaning the sewers in the year. Next, structural integrity of pipes. Next factor is structural integrity of pipes. You have to see the structural integrity, whenever you have designed the sewer pipeline, before going for inspection, cleaning and ventilation of the sewer pipes, you have to see the integrity, whether the structural lines are properly aligned or not. Is there any leaks in that or not? Is there any alignment problem? Alignment problem unda ledha check cheskovali. Leaks emanna unnaya check cheskovali. During cleaning any problems vastaya ledha check cheskovali. So these are the factors the structural integrity of pipe should be taken. Next, degree of cleanliness ante enta clean ga nuvu maintain chestunnavu. What is the degree? So degree means how much cleaning, very good cleaning, normal cleaning, or very very high cleaning, ante rating anamata. Cleanliness, once you have cleaned the process, the sewer line, you have to go for the degree of cleanliness. So what is the degree of cleanliness here? It gives whether you have cleaned perfectly 100% or 90% or 70%. So like this, you have to see the degree of cleanliness also. So this is also one of the factors considered for proper cleaning, right? Next. Next, what are the sewer cleaning equipment? So we'll see in this slide what are the equipments used for cleaning the appurtenances and also the sewer pipeline. First, rodding. So we'll discuss in detail. The first one is a rodding equipment. The second one is a sewer balls equipment. The third one, high velocity cleaner mobile transportation. So these vehicles we are already byte meer chuse untaru. This some sort of industrial vehicles where the sewage water is coming, is retracting from the sewer line into this tank with a high velocity jet, right? High velocity cleaner equipment. Next, bucket machine. The other one is bucket machine. The next one is a flushing process, flushing equipment. So these are the five main sewer cleaning equipment used for cleaning of sewage pipe as well as storm water drainage pipe, right? This is a rodding process, sewer ball mechanism, high velocity cleaner, bucket machine, and flushing of the sewer pipes. Next, what is the adverse outcomes of not cleaning? So whenever you are not cleaning, what are the effects you are facing, right? So if debris is allowed to accumulate, debris ante the waste, the acronym of the other meaning of this waste is debris. It is in the form of solid chatta, right? It may be the plastic covers, it may be the mud, it may be the paper, it may be the small sticks, it may be the household materials. It's like this. So whenever the debris is not allowed to accumulate, what happens? Reduction of the capacity of the pipe. The pipe will lose the capacity. Whenever the debris is accumulated ante mottam cherukodam, whenever the waste is settling at one point, the pipe will lose the capacity and automatically it will break or gets leakage. Second one, blockage. Obviously, whenever you are not maintaining the sewer pipeline, automatically blockage anedi vastundi whenever you are accumulating the debris. Next, overflow happens when blockage occur aithe overflow avutundi. Eppudu whenever the blockage lenappudu automatically the sewer pipe lonchi the sewage waste water anedi ellipothu untundi. So whenever blockage chote em jarugutundi, if you see some manholes outside in the road meeda chuste meer manholes avi ఓపెన్ చేసి ఉంటారు. దాని మీనింగ్ ఏంటి? ఒకటి, ప్రాపర్ వెంటిలేషన్ ఇవ్వడానికి ఓపెన్ చేస్తున్నారు. దట్ ఇస్ ఎ డిఫెక్ట్. ఇనిషియల్ గా ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ మెయింటైనింగ్ ద సీవర్ పైప్ లైన్ మ్యాన్ హోల్ ప్రాపర్లీ, అప్పుడు ఈ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ని స్టార్ట్ అవుతుంది. ఓపెన్ చేసి పక్కన పెట్టి ఒక 3-4 డేస్ తర్వాత వరకు వచ్చి మళ్ళీ దాన్ని కంట్రోల్ చేస్తారు. సో ద 3-4 డేస్ ఇట్ విల్ బి ఓపెన్ ఓన్లీ. వై? సో ఎప్పుడైతే ఓపెన్ చేసి ఉంటే ఏమంటారు, వెంటిలేషన్ ప్రాపర్ గా జరిగితే లోపల క్లీన్ చేయడానికి ఈజీగా ఉంటుంది అంటారు. వెన్నవర్ యు ఆర్ మెయింటైనింగ్ ద డెబ్రిస్ ని ప్రాపర్ గా మీరు బయటికి పంపించేస్తూ ఉంటే ఈ ప్రాబ్లం రాదు. ఓపెనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ద మ్యాన్ హోల్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్, మనకి ప్రతిరోజు ఎవ్రీ ఇయర్ మనకి న్యూస్ లో చెప్తున్నట్టు మ్యాన్ హోల్ లో మనుషులు పడిపోయారు చనిపోయారు ఊపిరాడకి చనిపోయారు సో లైక్ దిస్ యు ఆర్ గెట్టింగ్ ద ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ సో వై ఇనిషియల్లీ వీఆర్ నాట్ టేకింగ్ ప్రాపర్ కంట్రోల్ అండ్ మెజర్మెంట్స్ అందుకే ఇవన్నీ జరుగుతున్నాయి నెక్స్ట్ ఫిజికల్ డ్యామేజ్ టు ద సీవర్స్ ఆబ్వియస్లీ ఎప్పుడైతే మీకు సీవర్ పైప్ లో మీకు సాలిడ్ మ్యాటర్ డెబ్రిస్ ఎక్కువైపోతే ఏమవుతుంది ఆటోమేటిక్ గా సీవర్ పైప్ పగిలిపోయే ఛాన్సెస్ ఉంది లేకపోతే గ్రౌండ్ లోపలికి బయటకు వచ్చి అండర్ గ్రౌండ్ లోపల పగిలిపోయి మొత్తం నీకు వాటర్ ఎప్పుడు లీక్ అయిపోతూ ఉంటుంది దట్స్ వై ఇఫ్ యు సీ ఇన్ సమ్ ఏరియాస్ ఆన్ ద రోడ్ ద సీవర్ పైప్ లైన్స్ విల్ గెట్ డామేజ్డ్ దట్స్ వై ద వాటర్ విల్ ఫ్లో కంటిన్యూస్లీ ఆన్ ద రోడ్ అదంతా పాండ్ లాగా మడుగులాగా తయారవుతుంది సో లైక్ దిస్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ ఆల్రెడీ హ్యావ్ సీన్ సమ్వేర్ ఆన్ ద రోడ్ రైట్ Next, what are the methods of cleaning and clearing? So, rodding, mechanical, manual, hydraulic and chemical. So, enni rakaluga, enni methods we are using for cleaning the sewers ante manual method okati, mechanical method, hydraulic method and chemical method. So, we'll discuss this in step by step. Manual method. See a person is standing on the ground or a pavement and he is taking a stick or some bamboo stick or some sort of rod inserting inside and cleaning manually ee manually eppudu jarugutundi whenever the depth is low eppudaithe depth takkuvaga undi pani takkuvaga unnappudu manual method cheyadaniki aaskaram chances unnayi right see here the long strips from bamboo stem are taken and tailored to use as a sewer cleaning rod between two consecutive manholes లాంగ్ స్ట్రిప్స్ ఆఫ్ బ్యాంబూ బ్యాంబూ అంటే ఏంటి వెదురు పొంగు సో దే ఆర్ టేకింగ్ ద బ్యాంబూ స్టేక్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్లాంట్స్ అండ్ దే ఆర్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ క్లీనింగ్ రాడ్ సో దాన్ని మనం క్లీనింగ్ రాడ్ లాగా యూజ్ చేసేవాళ్ళు బిట్వీన్ ద టూ కన్సెక్యూటివ్ మ్యాన్ హోల్స్ పక్క పక్కన ఉన్న మ్యాన్ హోల్స్ విత్ లెస్ డెప్త్ ఉన్న మ్యాన్ హోల్స్ దే ఆర్ యూజింగ్ ఇన్ దిస్ ప్రాసెస్ నెక్స్ట్ క్రూ మీన్స్ ద పీపుల్ If the crew is essentially doing only hand rodding, at least two operators are recommended. So, ఎప్పుడైతే హ్యాండ్ రాడ్ మాన్యువల్ గా చేస్తున్నారో ఈ వెదురు బొంగులు కర్రలు తీసుకొని ఎప్పుడైతే హ్యాండ్ రాడింగ్ ప్రాసెస్ చేస్తున్నారో at least two operators are used for this process. One is for maintenance man one, other one is maintenance man two. So, ఇద్దరు ఆపరేటర్స్ మనకి యూజ్ అవుతారు అందులో ఒకరిని మనం ఏమంటున్నాం మెయింటెనెన్స్ మ్యాన్ వన్ అంటున్నాము ఇంకొకరిని మెయింటెనెన్స్ మ్యాన్ టూ అని చెప్తున్నాము రైట్ నెక్స్ట్ మెకానికల్ మెథడ్ లో వీఆర్ యూజింగ్ సమ్ వెహికల్స్ ఆర్ సమ్ మెషినరీ ఫర్ డూయింగ్ ద ప్రాసెస్ సో ఇన్ ద మెకానికల్ ప్రాసెస్ లో వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ పౌడర్ రాడర్ అండ్ బకెట్ వించ్ మెషిన్ ఆర్ వించ్ మెషిన్ If you see this figure, so if this is a manhole, this is a sewer line, the vehicles are on the road, they are extracting the material from the manhole and extracting it, taking into the winch machine. So these are the setup what you are seeing here. Next, the power rodding machines use a steel rod to push or pull various cleaning tools through sewers. So ఒక స్టీల్ రాడ్ తీసుకొని పవర్ రాడర్ లో పవర్ అంటే ఆటోమేటికల్లీ we are using electricity current for moving front and back whereas manual lo manam chetto chestunnam ikkada manamu using power we are using the process now if you see the power rodding machines use a steel rod to push or pull various cleaning tools through the sewers right second one these machines are of various designs and are equipped with a rod in a reel having lengths up to approximately 1000 feet these machines are of various designs annunnadu and are equipped with a rod with a reel so reel laga untund anamata oka pedda reel round coil laga untundi they will take that one and they will keep inside the sewer line and dig deeper and deeper pushing and pulling next this reel can be rotated to give turning action as a rod is pushed or removed ante kada so whenever the power rod అంటే ఒక పెద్ద పవర్ రాడ్ పైప్ కి స్టార్టింగ్ లో మనకు ఒక పెద్ద స్టీల్ రాడ్ అటాచ్ అయి ఉంటుంది దిస్ స్టీల్ రాడ్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ ఇన్ సైడ్ ద సీవర్ ఆర్ మ్యాన్ హోల్ పుషింగ్ ఆర్ పుల్లింగ్ మెథడ్ దేర్ బై పవర్ డ్రివెన్ కాబట్టి ద వేస్ట్ అంతా సక్ చేసుకొని ఆ పైప్ లోంచి మనకి ఇట్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ అవుట్ ఆర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గివింగ్ ద ఎయిర్ సప్లై సో ఎయిర్ ప్రెషర్ సప్లై చేస్తున్నప్పుడల్లా ఆటోమేటిక్ గా లోపల ఉన్నదంతా క్లీన్ జరుగుతుంటుంది Next, rodding operation. Then what is the rodding operation you are doing? Using a proper controls of the rodder, push rod and clearing tool into the line of few feet and slowly start rotating the rod in the clockwise direction. Do not jam the rod into an obstruction. Do not rotate the rod in one position for extended periods. So these are some of the steps to be followed while the operation is going on. Okay, na? Next. Now, the second one is a bucket or winch machine. Bucket or winch machine. So, see here. So, manaki towing machines ani meeru baita rodni chuse untaru. What is the meaning of towing machine? So, towing vehicle. ఎప్పుడైతే మీరు కార్ పార్కింగ్ స్కూటర్ పార్కింగ్ మీరు ఇంప్రాపర్ ప్లేసెస్ లో మీరు లాక్ చేసి వెళ్ళారో, ఎక్కడైతే మీకు నో పార్కింగ్ అని పెట్టారో అక్కడ మీరు కార్ పార్క్ చేస్తే ఆటోమేటికలీ దిస్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ వెహికల్ కమ్స్ అండ్ లిఫ్ట్ ద కార్ అండ్ టేక్ టు ద పోలీస్ స్టేషన్. సో దట్ ఇస్ అ సింపుల్ సిమిలర్ టు దట్ ఆఫ్ ద బకెట్ మెషిన్ ఆర్ వించ్ మెషిన్. హియర్ ద పొజిషన్ టూ మెషిన్స్ ఓవర్ ద రెస్పెక్టివ్ మ్యాన్ హోల్స్ ద పొజిషన్ the position two machines. They will keep two machines over the manhole where they want to clean. Place the pads under the stabilizer feet of the machine and jack them down so that the weight of the machine holds the pads on the place. So em chestaru, once the machine anedi akkada set chesin tarvata danlo nunchi oka stems kindaku vastayi. Stems ante hydraulic legs laga kindaku vastundi. Then they will jack it and then they will lock on the road. Thereby the weight of the machine when controls the pad and the total weight of the machine. Third point enti, the lower manhole roller is lowered in the manhole. So the next thing jarugutundi dan aa winch machine lo nunchi oka big rod roller is going into the manhole. To thread the sewer, a synthetic rope can be used. So for threading, what you are using a synthetic rope. To this rope attach a nylon parachute designed for such use and allow the parachute to float downstream to the working manhole. The cleaning bucket is now ready to be attached to the cable. Just like a winch machine ante if you see any Srisalem or some other places in a hilly areas manaku winch untundi, means a cable car, how they are going in the air, they are going and dropping the people and again coming in the other line. So in the same way, in the winch machine also, the buckets are arranged. Thereby, the buckets are going deeper into the sewer or manhole pipe, and they are retrieving the material and coming to the other line. So this is a way of doing the process. Okay, na? Next, what are the precautions and safety to be measured? Regular inspect cable clamps, clips and squills, bucket condition, cable condition, condition of accessories. So what are the precautions you have to take? Regularly we have to inspect the accessories and the assemblies which is on this winch machine, where to respond properly without any problem. Next, if buckets are placed, because don't try to force away through it.
What is the next thing? If the bucket becomes lodged, don't try to force your way through. So when the buckets are placed on a certain places, when the buckets are placed on certain places on the winch, don't try to remove when they are in a locked condition. Be careful when lowering the bucket into the working manhole. So whenever the bucket is lowering into the manhole through this winch machine, so it is slowly in a hanging mode and moving around because of the weight. It is in the moving, just oscillating mode. So we should be very careful and we should not stand near the bucket whenever it is lowering into the manhole. Next, personal safety must be stressed when using the cable operated equipment. Ante kada. So these are all cable operating the jarugutundi. So this process, everything is done by the cable ante oka strong wire, metal wire tho jarugutundi. So personal safety anedi chaala mukhyam. Why? Because whenever the cable anedi cut ayipindi ankonde, automatically the jam anna avutundi, ledante equipment will fall on you personal, thereby you will get injured. So like this, you have to take the precautions while doing the winching operation. Next one is hydraulic method. First one, manual method, mechanical method, and hydraulic method. Now, see in the hydraulic method, what you are having. So, hydraulic method engineering in the vehicle lorry. Backside, you are having a big horizontal tank where you are taking the water through the pipes. Next, high velocities, high water velocities can efficiently remove the grease, sand, and other debris. First one is the flushing method. Other one is jetting and sucking method. First one is a flushing method in hydraulic methods. Second one is jetting and sucking method. What's happening in this here? So the flushing method of a hydraulic cleaning is occasionally used at the beginning of the collection system where low or sluggish flows permit the deposition of solids. So where we are using this hydraulic system, the flushing system, wherever there are low flows of sewage pipe and also deposition of solids, in such areas we are using the flushing method, which are used at the beginning of the collection system. So initial stage is low. Eppudaithe receiver design chesaro, so at that time manaki the solid deposits gaani, the flow of water gaani initially untundi kabatti, at such places we are using this flushing methods for cleaning the manhole. See here, the person is standing on the road and he is having a pipe inserting into the manhole or sewer line. Then he is flushing with the water and it is cleaned. Then what is the startup operation? Start the flushing operation at the extreme upstream end. So we have to start the flushing operation at the extreme upstream end and starting initial position. Start top position, we have to start the process. Next, place the water line over the manhole. So you have to place the water line over the manhole, at the top of the manhole. Clean the manhole first. So initially go for the first cycle of cleaning. Next, after you have dumped some of the water, observe if there is any evidence of water backup. So whenever you have dumped the first cycle, pouring of water on the manhole, observe if there is any evidence of water. So before leaving the going for the second cycle, observe is there any patterns, if there are any marks of water present on the manhole or not. Next, observe the water flowing in the downstream manhole and look for the signs of grease, roots, and other debris that are creating a restriction. Next, manaki upper layer upstream to manaki manhole process ayin tarvata, whenever you are going to the second level, that is downstream of the manhole, observe carefully the signs ante gurtulu, grease marakalu, dani roots, ledante any solid debris emana obstruct chestunna leda ivanni check cheyali. Next, close the manhole and go to the next downstream manhole. So once the process is done, close the manhole and go for the next downstream manhole. Next downstream ante din tarvata vache mount downstream manhole ki you have to go. Upstream avasaram ledu, downstream kellal ante once oka manhole ikkada undi, other manhole ikkada undi, other manhole ikkada undi, ela chestaru kinda nunchi paiki ellagoddu, pai nunchi kindaku vastu raavali, right? Next, this operation will be repeated from manhole to manhole. So for example, మనకి ఒక 5 మ్యాన్ హోల్స్ ఉన్నాయి అనుకోండి, 5 4 3 2 1 అట్లా రాకూడదు, 1 2 3 4 5 అట్లా చేసుకుంటూ టిల్ ద కంప్లీషన్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రాసెస్ వి హావ్ టు గో ఫర్ దిస్ ప్రాసెస్. నెక్స్ట్ మెథడ్ ఇస్ జెట్టింగ్ అండ్ సక్కింగ్. సో ద యూజ్ ఆఫ్ హైడ్రాలిక్ ప్రెస్ టు డీ స్లిఫ్ట్ ఆఫ్ సీవర్ డేట్స్ బ్యాక్ టు ద 9. సో ఇట్ ఇస్ నాట్ న్యూ మెథడ్ బై యూజింగ్ ద హైడ్రాలిక్స్, ఇట్ ద వెరీ ఓల్డెస్ట్ మెథడ్ విచ్ ఇస్ యూజ్డ్ ఇన్ ద 1900s. However, this method has been developed with the passage of time by using the high velocity cleaning machine. High velocity cleaning machines are confidently used to stoppages, remove the grease, cleanliness of debris, and wash manholes and wet wells. So the same way what you have taken precautions for this your mechanical method, for hydraulics also you have to take the measurements of safety. regularly inspect the cable clamps, tailbase wheels, bucket condition, cable condition, condition of the accessories. If bucket is large, don't try to force your way through. Be careful while lowering the bucket into the manhole. The same precautions what you are taking for the mechanical thing, the same thing you should be applied for the hydraulics also, right? So in this way, the hydraulic methods are used for cleaning of the ventilation, cleaning of the sewer pipes. The next one, ventilation of the sewer systems. So ventilation and TNT, for every house you are having a ventilation, right? Ventilators. What is the use of ventilators? To escape of the poisonous gases or the waste gases, waste smell, odor smell in the house to the atmosphere. And also fresh air is also entering into the house or a chamber, right? Proper ventilation, sewers ki proper ventilation is there automatically the debris whatever inside will get solidified and automatically it will get composed, or else what happens, it will not decompose. Okay, na? Now see, in modern plumbing process, a drain waste vent, drain ante outing. So in the bathroom ki drain pipe untundi kada, that is nothing but the ventilator. For example, if you see in your bathroom or if your house top lo meer oka pipe pettaru, pipe petti daniki konni jali untundi, jali means the air flow anedi untundi akkada. So how, why you are designing that one? It is nothing but a drain pump. It is nothing but a drain waste vent, nothing but a DWV. Is part of a system that allows air to enter a plumbing system to maintain a proper air pressure to enable the removal of sewage and grey water from the dwelling. Grey water means the same, the whatever the మీరు కాలువలో ఉండే వాటర్ గ్రే వాటర్, రైట్? ఫ్రమ్ ద వెల్డింగ్, వెల్డింగ్ మీన్స్ రిప్రొడక్షన్, ప్రొడక్షన్. మళ్ళీ అక్కడ చెత్త చేరిపోయి ఏం జరుగుతుంది, బ్యాక్టీరియా ఫామ్ అవుతుంది. ఆటోమేటికల్లీ ఆ చెత్తలో నుంచి బ్యాక్టీరియా ఫామ్ అయ్యి ఇట్ విల్ మల్టిప్లై ద వేస్ట్. నెక్స్ట్, వేస్ట్ ఈస్ ప్రొడ్యూస్డ్ అట్ ఫిక్చర్స్ సచ్ అస్ టాయిలెట్స్, సింక్స్ అండ్ షవర్స్. వేర్ ద వేస్ట్ ఈస్ ప్రొడ్యూస్డ్ ఇన్ శానిటీ ఇన్ డొమెస్టిక్ ప్లేసెస్, ద టాయిలెట్ ప్లేసెస్, సింక్ ప్లేసెస్ అండ్ shower places. As the water runs down, proper venting is required to avoid the vacuum from being created. As the water runs down, air must be allowed into the waste pipe either through the roof vent or the drain waste vent. So if point em cheptunnaru, as the water is running down, air must be allowed. As the water runs down, air must be allowed into the waste pipe. So that's why if you see the roof vent, either through the roof vent, rendu rakaluga okati enti vent paina unna roof vent untundi kada, so by using that thing, the air must be allowed into the waste pipe or by the drain waste vent. Drain waste anedi meeku toilets outer inti bayata meeku oka setting untundi. So like that also you have to maintain the drain waste vent or roof vent in order to escape the gases in the sewer pipe. Now the ventilation is a process by which clean air is intentionally provided to a space and stale air is removed. Stale air ante the bad air, the fused, the fumes air in the is removed from the sewer to the outside. The corresponding loss of air from an enclosed space is termed as exfiltration. Okay, na? Now the ventilation is a process by which a clean air ekkada dorukutundi, normally outside in the atmosphere, is intentionally provided to the space, the bad air is removed. Okay, na? The venting system or plumbing vents in a sewer system consists of number of pipes leading from the waste pipes to the outdoors, usually through the roof. Roof kunna venting dwara, whatever the things happening in the kitchen room or in the toilet, it will escape into the outside through the plumbing vents. Next, what is a ventilation pipe? A ventilation pipe or a flue is connecting an interior space in the building with the outer air for a purpose of ventilation. Ante a pipe anedi, a ventilator pipe is nothing but it is a physical physical setup placed for the moving of air in and out for the purpose of ventilation. Any small pipe extending from any various plumbing fixtures in the structure is connected to the vent stack. The vent pipes also allow oxygen into the waste pipes, but when water moves through the pipe, it compresses the air ahead of it, creating a positive pressure. Obviously, when the vent pipes allow the oxygen, generally the vent pipes allow the oxygen in the atmosphere into the waste pipes, but when the water moves through the pipe, it compresses the air. Air ni compress chesi creates a positive pressure inside the pipe. Next. The vent pipes allow the sewer gases to escape to outside. Ante kada, the vent pipes are designed at your house to escape of the poisonous gas, to escape of the sewer gas outside rather than being released inside the house. So if you have exhaust fan in one room, whenever your mother or whenever you are doing the kitchen, whenever you are doing your work in the kitchen, so that the exhaust fan is on just pit call. Whenever the exhaust fan is on, what happens? What happens? Whatever the fumes, whatever the gases, whatever the vapor is inside the kitchen room, it will escape outside. And together, the same thing the vent pipe also does in this process. Now see the different designs of the vent pipes, where you can see for domestic areas or in the industrial areas. Now see, this is the general structure of the sewer, the ventilation pipeline. So these are the various columns where you are doing placing the applications. This one is a ventilator which is placed on the top surface of the building, apartment, house or any industry. Now if you see the line diagram, this is the house. This is the house. This is a building drain is going into the septic tank. The other pipe is having some fixture, and fixture means some application, some tap or some other application in the kitchen room, and directly it is having the vent pipe, right? So this is, now see this one. This is a ventilation for the manhole where it is placed on the roadside, that is in the pavement degra manhole to ventilator cap kuda untundi. So here is a vent pipe. This is a vent open air where the air fumes, the inorganic air fumes, the chemical process are going outside to the atmosphere. See this one, the various designs, various diameters of the ventilator system which are placed on the top surface. Now see, this is a house or apartment. See, from the drainage pipes, the sewer pipes, right, the pipe is connected to the top surface and it is vented in this manner, right? These are the ventilator figures where you are using for different applications. Next, methods of ventilation. Any rakaluga manam ventilation ivvachu. The various gases produced in the sewers due to the purification of organic matters in the sewage, these gases are very foul in nature and very foul and negative in nature, causes harmful to the human beings and corrode the sewers. Sewer ni corrode chestundi. The gases so produced are highly explosive and may cause accidents also. So that's why meer paper lo eppudu chuste manholes lo kelli workers clean chestu naluguru oopiraadaku chanipoyaru antaru. Oopiraadaku chanipoyaru ante enti? The government or official, the people, they are not wearing the gas mask or oxygen cylinders and entering into the manhole. Adoka problem ledante, whenever you are cleaning the manholes, appudu em jarugutundi? The foul, the whatever the purification organic matter, whatever the gases, em avutundi? It will become very health hazardous for the human, and thereby these gases produce very highly explosive and may cause to accidents. Ante maskulu pettukoru, right? At the same time, whenever they are going deeper into the sewer line, automatically oxygen levels are tagipothundi. Automatically, because of this explosive gases, because of the fume gases inside available in the pipeline, idi ekkuva ipesaru oxygen levels takkuvayi, automatically the people will die in the manholes itself, right? Due to the above difficulties, the sewers must be properly ventilated. The following methods are, for the first method here, use ventilating columns. Ventilating shafts helps to remove the foul and explosive gases produced in the sewer. So shaft in the chapunam jusara, the shaft you should maintain properly. They provide fresh air to the workers working in the manholes. They also help to prevent the formation of air locks in the sewage, thereby ensuring the continuous flow of sewage proper in the sewer. For the first one, make proper ventilating shafts or column. Use ventilating manhole covers. The manhole covers are sometimes provided with the perforations and holes anamata square lo gaane round lo gaane holes untai dan meeda through which the sewer gets exposed to atmosphere. The ventilation itla design chesina kuda the sewer gas anedi bayatiki ellipothundi. This will help in achieving some ventilation but will cause more nuisance ante enti dan lopala solid waste padutundi road meeda untundi kabatti ledanni dan lopala intentional ga evaranna రాళ్ళు ప్లాస్టిక్ బాటిల్స్ వేసే ఛాన్సెస్ ఉంది. నెక్స్ట్ థర్డ్ వన్, ప్రాపర్ ద డిజైన్, ప్రాపర్లీ డిజైన్ ద సీవర్స్. సో ఇనిషియల్ గా మనం డిజైన్ చేస్తున్నప్పుడు ప్రాపర్ గా చేయమని ఇస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఫర్ వెంటిలేషన్. నెక్స్ట్ యూజ్ ఆఫ్ మెకానికల్ డివైజెస్. ఫోర్స్డ్ డ్రాట్ ఈస్ సమ్టైమ్స్ ప్రొవైడెడ్ బై ఎగ్జాస్ట్ ఫ్యాన్స్ టు ఎక్స్పెల్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ఫౌల్ గ్యాసెస్ ఫ్రమ్ ద సీవర్స్. మెట్రోపాలిటన్ సిటీస్ లో మనకి సీవర్ పైప్స్ లోపల సెట్టింగ్ ఎక్కువ పెద్దగా ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి we can use some exhaust fan inside the sewer pipeline. House vent and soil pipes use directly help in ventilation house drains and public services, right? Next, house products, artificial ventilation. Sometimes artificial ventilation is also arranged at the site before entering the sewer by blowing fresh air into the sewer through the mechanical means. So whenever you are designing the sewer line, so in some cases the natural ventilation construction time lo jaragadu kabatti in such cases we have to use artificial ventilation by arranging the blower pipes or the pump pipes into the sewer in order to create the artificial ventilation, right? Next, so with this the unit 1 is completed. So everything is discussed in the slides. All the unit 1 topics are discussed in the slides. Please go through. And so I am taking the attendance in this for this class. Okay, so in the next class we'll discuss the unit 2 and also some questions what will come in the exam also, right? So after a few minutes this video is uploaded in the YouTube. Just open the link and watch the video and see the views also liking videos. Thank you one and all. If you have any doubts, just you can share me. You are having less time. Open your mic and you can speak to me.